Good evening, all you lovely people out there. And how are you?
I wasn't ready.
You weren't ready. Oh, sorry.
We'll go. We'll keep going anyway. Because you know, this what we do. We're never ready. We just
go for it, don't we?
I mean, we are day four into it, and we're already breaking at the seams. We're
day
like,
four of 22. We're like, what we're gonna do next?
What the fuck are we gonna do next? I mean,
so welcome to all you lovely people out there, anyway, and welcome to day four.
Yeah.
So, we thought this evening we'd show you some not seen clips of the up and coming comedy movie that's been in production for a fair while, would you say, Nicholas?
12 years, I think it
is.
We started just after we finished the comedy show in, was it 2006 or 2007? Mm. So the comedy show went on for 10 years, but it had a break in between series 1 and 2. Mm.
And was the Steve show in between, or
Steve's show was the first series aired between series 4 and 5, and the second series aired after series 5.
Okay, I see. So it's hard to remember. Yeah, it's such a long time ago.
Yeah, that's why.
No, can't just start off the music.
I know.
The comedy show has got funny things that you should know.
The comedy show
is starting in a mo. And here's your hosts,
Nicholas Reed
and Stephen Reed.
Footage better than I do. Why don't you just explain a little bit about what people are going to see?
I thought we'd start, you know, at the beginning. I mean,
that seems a very good place to start.
I mean, the comedy show is obviously NickeRMel's first ever project. I mean, I think I've described it this way many a times. It's just me, a 9-year-old kid, fucking about on the beach, and my uncle, and this sounds wrong now describing it, was just filming me on the beach, and I just decided to do random crap.
And it was essentially the first comedy show.
Yeah, and essentially everything spawned from that. And you can blame, I suppose, both me and my uncle for starting it all off.
Thank you. Now you see we're at the beach with my mom.
Yeah.
With additions from Melanie.
Yeah, of course. I mean, me and Melanie decided to, you know, create the company, and, you know, we've been running it since then and spanning off and stuff. But at the heart of it, for at least the first 10 years, the comedy show was always there. And we were always working on it. Mm. And what was so unique about the comedy show is it was sort of in its own reality, where we're in the reality where we're like famous reality stars, and we host this reality show called The Comedy Show. So the show itself is a show within a show. And they tend to be my favourite episodes, is when we break away from the talk show part of the episode and it's actually set within that reality when we're not filming the show, and it's just about us doing random things. Like, I think my favourite, I don't know about you, but I think my favourite episode of both The Comedy Show and Steve's show is probably the last episode of The Comedy Show. The death of Nicholas Reed.
Yeah.
Just because it's so well put together. And ironically, even though it's the last episode of the 10-year show, I think it's where I finally started to find my footing with like filming and like creating the story.
Yeah.
Right. Hey, mate. Just don't fuck around with it, alright? It's dangerous.
What was that?
It's a gun. He needs it. Death threats.
Oh.
What, do you want one?
No, I found mail.
Oh. Careful with it, it goes off the phone sometimes.
Okay.
Fucking movie.
How about you? Of comedy show and Steve show, there must be an episode.
There are so many.
You mentioned one to me earlier about Steve show.
Was it the penultimate Steve show?
It might not be the penultimate, it's definitely the second series.
I was able to be granted by, I can't even remember how, my wishes.
It was like a bucket list or something. I can't remember the structure of why he was doing it, but basically each scene was you living out your fantasy.
Being at the top of the Eiffel Tower, being with two women, drinking, something else. There were about 10 different things.
I think there might have even been
benighted, wasn't it?
Oh, God, yeah, I forgot about that.
Benighted, yes.
Your Majesty. I dub thee, Sir Stephen of Buckner.
And that was one of my favourites.
I think what's great about the second series of Steve's show is it keeps the momentum of that last episode of the comedy show with a structured storytelling method, because series two, even though they're all individual stories, continues the storyline. I mean, the first episode is me in a coma after being shot, which
is setting up
the movie in the first place. And then throughout the series, you're checking up on me, but I was a minute, and I finally kind of obviously wake up at the end of Steve's show. But what's not revealed in that last episode, which is now revealed in this movie, is there's been a bit of a time jump. Because obviously, when we first started this movie, we didn't expect it to take 12, 13 years to make. So, I think, how many script rewrites has there been?
Oh,
five?
Maybe, yeah.
Because, I think and it's always the third act that's changed the most.
Yeah.
And it's always where the kind of confrontation starts with kind of, let's say, the antagonist of the film, even though I wouldn't really say there is a main antagonist in the film. But that third act has changed so much. First, it was the core scene was the same, but the supporting cast in the scene has changed. Like, first, it was supposed to be Melanie, Deborah and Lawrence coming back to the rescue from Spain, and then when we couldn't get them back, it became Elliot. When they couldn't come back, it became Elliot and Harvey, because crap shows were still running at that time. Yeah. So we thought we'd bring them in, and that's where this kind of universe of I kind of like to call it the limited gene pool universe, because crap shows and the comedy show and all that are kind of semi-set in the same world,
As you'll see in these clips. As with Freddy and the Funkbuckers.
They're all set in the same kind of universe.
Because
that's another thing as well, we kind of set up the crossover.
We did, with Freddy turning up at the door.
And even with that scene that I just showed you earlier.
Of course, with the music.
Yeah.
And Steve saying they stole my music.
And of course, the happy slapper from Crap Show shows up as well. I mean, we're giving a bit too much away here. We just wanted to kind of, you know, lay the background a bit, throw some stuff in there, and show
and
you
watch and enjoy some clips.
Yeah, I mean, the chunk you're about to see is probably the majority of the opening of the film, minus a few scenes that haven't been shot or have been cut. But this is essentially how the film begins, plus maybe an extra scene or two here and there, just to kind of get gist of...
Get the fun of it.
So, shall we leave it at that then?
Let's leave it at that, and we'll say goodbye to these lovely people and let them enjoy the...
Well, we don't know it's clips. Lovely people. Some racist or some paedophile might be watching this video. White supremacist might be like... whatever they say, and we might be supporting them, and we shouldn't be. That's bad. So if you're watching, you can fuck right off.
Go away.
This isn't for you.
Get out of here.
That's another thing that's set in the same universe as well.
Derek and Clive.
Yeah, exactly. Even though that's never formally connected, but if we ever did, sorry, we're talking about future projects here, and I shouldn't talk about that yet. Right. Anyway.
Shall we say farewell?
Yes, farewell on...
Day 4 of 22.
I was actually going to go prompting you with on with the show, but...
On with the show?
Too late, you've ruined the moment.
Do it again.
No.
Okay.
It's fine. We'll accept it, won't we?
We're starting in a mo.
Shall we do that to sign off with it?
Go on then.
The comedy show, got funny things that you should know. The comedy show is starting in a mo. And here's your host, Nicholas Reed and Stephen Reed.
Right, see you later.
Bye.
I've just remembered something, but bye anyway. Bye.
So you're probably wondering how I got here. Well, let's go back and see. Okay, maybe we need to go back a little bit further. Okay, let's start again. You see, a while ago, I got shot. I'd been receiving these death threats from some weirdo saying if I didn't give up my day job, he would kill me. Me, doing the stupid thing, decided to ignore these warnings. Then I was a goner. I was in a coma for 6 months, not being able to do anything. Not even have a wank. When suddenly...
It's alive!
I woke up.
Nick!
Nick, are you okay?
Nick!
What happened?
You were shot, don't you remember?
Oh, yeah. What?
Yes, you were shot. We're not quite sure who did it. We thought it might be that mysterious stalker.
Oh. How long have I been out?
About 6 months.
Oh.
Hey, Nick. Don't you think you'd better put some clothes on?
Hello, and welcome to the comedy show. Today...
Okay, let's welcome back the Bud Puckers.
What the?
Family tree.
Oh, Daddy.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here's Freddy and the Fudpuckers win Family Tree.
The bastards!
Ready to go.
No.
Yes, motherfucker.
Nick, haven't seen you for a while. How are you?
I'm good, thanks. Elliot and Harvey in?
Yes, they are. Hang on a minute, I'll just get them for you. Harvey! Elliot! Can you get your asses down here? Nick's here!
Elliot, you twit! Golf!
Hey guys.
You're alright!
Yeah, otherwise I wouldn't be standing here.
Oh, it's good to see you, mate!
Yeah, El, no, kinda couldn't be here.
Oh, right, yeah, right. Huh.
I hear you are my doctor.
Ah, Harvey Crossley, MD. At your service.
Cool. Right, let's go out.
Hello.
Where's Nick? I heard he woke up.
Oh, he's just popped out to say hi to Elliot and Harvey.
Oh, well, I'm going on holiday today.
Again?
Yeah, well, when Beezy gets home, give him all my love.
Okay.
Well, let's roll out.
Oh no, not again.
Why does this always happen to me?
Face it, Nick, nobody really likes you. Did I just say that out loud? Aren't you going to open it then?
I thought I'd leave the death-threatening letters for today.
Can I open it?
Whatever.
So, how you been, mate?
Yeah, me too. Haven't seen you in years.
What, tonight?
Yeah, sure.
Well,
that is a funny story. You know what? I'll tell you tonight. Alright, see you then. Bye!
Hey, Nick! Rather than trying to kill you this time, he's threatening to cut off your balls and stick them down your mouth. Hey Nick, What does Gooch mean?
I got a call from Joe tonight. He wants to meet up.
Well, I'll see you later then.
Yes, you will.
So, Stephen, how are you doing these days?
Not good, Doctor. I've got a lot of stress in my life right now. And Nick's finally woken up after 5 years.
And what about your birth situation?
It's getting worse. I feel like he's taking me over. Even on the way here, I thought I saw him following me. What should I do?
Stephen, I think it's time to face facts. You're a crackpot. You should book yourself into the nearest mental institute straight away.
Well, before I do that, I need to speak to my son's doctor.
So, do you think Nick will be okay?
I believe so, yeah. I mean, he may have severe brain damage and may end up clucking like a chicken, but I'm sure that'll suit him just fine. I'm just messing with you.
Considering where Nick was at the time, it seems likely he might have seen who shot him. Do you think he'll ever remember who it was?
Well, only time will tell.
That's exactly what my father said to me when I asked him if I'd ever lose my virginity. Oh, bugger! There's something I've forgotten to do.
Hello, Melanie. Uncle Stephen here. Before you say anything, I've got something to tell you. Nick's awake. Oh, no, you don't have to... Oh, okay.